sir.
Yes, 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 sir.
Our cultured audience tells me that Malavika Agnimitram, a play by Kalidasa, should be performed at the Spring Festival. Let's begin the production.
Oh, no! How can we disregard the works of widely celebrated poets like Basa and Saumila and Kaviputra and choose this composition by Kalidasa, a modern poet?
Now you voice a valid concern, my friend, but consider, not all old poetry is good, nor new bad. The wise search to discern one from the other, whose foolish minds are guided by the opinions of others.
True, sir. Very true. I thought
so. And be quick, sir.
Yes, sir.
For like these expert players in the service of Queen Dharini, I wish to fulfill the audience's request, accepted earlier with a bow.
Queen Dharini commands me to ask the dance teacher, Master Gandasa, how Malvika is progressing with the Charikam dance that she just started learning. I'll check the music hall.
Samudita, my dear.
Why so serious? You pass so close without even a glance.
Oh, Bakula Malika, my friend, I deserve that comment. I was so absorbed in the sparkling signet ring, engraved with the serpent seal, that I just picked up from the queen's jeweler.
The golden glow from that ring catches the eye. It's like a flower blooming at your fingertips.
By the way, where are you going, my friend?
By order of the queen, I'm going to see the dance teacher, Master Gandasa, to learn how Malvika is doing with her lessons.
But she's kept so far away and busy. How did the king even see her?
Well, he saw her beside the queen in a picture.
How?
Listen, the queen once went to the art gallery and stood staring at the fresh red paint on the master's canvas. And then the king arrived.
Then what?
The king greeted the queen and sat down beside her in the same chair. And looking at the painting, he noticed a lady seated among the queen's attendants and asked,
what did he ask?
This mysterious woman beside you, my queen, what's her name?
A fine body is certainly a cause for desire. Then what?
The queen ignored the king's question, but he persisted repeatedly on his own. Then Princess Vasulakshmi said, my lord, she's Malvika.
Oh, the innocence of a child. Tell me, what happened next?
What else is there? Malvika was immediately sent away and kept out of the king's sight.
You should attend to your work now, and I must bring this ring to the queen.
The dance teacher is leaving the music hall. I'll go to him now.
Granted, everyone's hereditary knowledge is well respected, but the reverence paid to our dance traditions isn't false. It's the truth. Sages value its peaceful living ritual to the gods. Its two distinct parts blend together, like Uma joined in Shiva's own body. The ways of the world rising from the three qualities are depicted on stage with various emotions. And though different people are of varying tastes, dance delights them, one and all.
Greetings, Master.
Live long, my lady.
Sir, the queen hopes Malvika isn't frustrating you too much as she learns her lessons.
My lady, inform the queen that Malvika is most talented and really very smart. What's more, each movement I demonstrate to express a particular emotion, the young girl betters in execution, as if she were teaching me instead.
Sounds like she's better than Iravati. So, your student is quite accomplished. As a guru, you must be pleased.
My lady, the dance is quite difficult. It makes wonder how she was brought to the queen.
The queen has a half-brother named Veersena. He's a commander stationed in the frontier fortress on the banks of Narmada. He found the girl to have some artistic talent and sent her as a gift to his sister, the queen.
Oh, her distinguished appearance makes me think she's not of low birth. My lady, she will surely make me famous. For when a teacher's art is imparted to a worthy student, its quality really changes. Like cloud water turning to pearl in an ocean oyster.
Really? So where's the student?
Oh, I just taught her a few abhinayas and told her to rest. She's standing at the window now looking out at the breeze.
Then let me go to her, sir, and inspire her further with his master's praise.
Sure, go see your friend. I'll get a moment alone.
Enter the king with his minister.
What does the king of Vidarbha say?
He has killed his own destruction, my lord.
I want to hear the message.
As you wish, my lord. This is his latest response. Your grace said the following. Your cousin, the noble prince Madhav Sena, who was promised in marriage to us, was assaulted and captured by your frontier guardsmen while passing through the borders of Mairan. Out of respect for me, release him, along with his wife and sister. Surely, you agree that there must be respect between kings of equal stature. Madhav Sena's sister was lost in the confusion surrounding the capture, and I'll make every effort to find her. As for the prince, I'll release him only if you heed my demands. If your grace frees my wife's brother, the captive Mauryan minister, I will immediately release Madhav Sena from his imprisonment.
Does this fool expect me to engage in making deals? Vatva, otherwise our natural enemy and the king harbors hostility. Since he positions himself so carelessly, give the order as we had planned earlier for the battalion led by Veera Sena to mount a full-scale attack.
As you wish, my lord.
Would you suggest otherwise?
You speak in accordance with foreign policy, my lord. A newly enthroned enemy, not yet popular with his subject, is easily routed out like freshly planted sapling.
Cotillia's principles are most true. Use these words to enlist the general.
So it shall be.
Gautam. The minister, Gautam, enters.
You know what? The king, his majesty, asked me this morning, Gautama, I saw Malavika in a picture by chance. Devise a way for me to see her in person. So you know what? I've done just that, and I'm waiting to tell him all about my plan. So you hang on and see what just happens.
Here comes my vice minister of internal affairs.
Oh, praise you, my lord.
Sit down. In your clever eye, did you find a way to see Malvika?
Rather ask how the plan is laid.
What's the plan?
Here's the plan.
Excellent, my friend. How clever you are. And though the success seems difficult, we must be hopeful. For a king only completes a challenging task with the help of a friend. For even a man with perfect vision needs light to see in the dark.
Enough of the excessive boasting, my friend.
Oh yeah? Only in the king's presence can we decide which one of us is better.
Oh
boy. My friend, the flower blooms in your well-planted seeds.
And before too long, you'll see it bear fruit.
Your Majesty, the minister sends word that your command is there. On the other matter, Haradatta and Giridhasa are here. Two masters of expressions, each seeking victory over other, are eager to see you in person, like two embodied emotions.
Let them enter.
As you command. This way, my lord.
What an intimidating regal persona. He's not unfamiliar nor unsightly, but I tremble in his presence. He's but himself and like the ocean, new to my eyes in every moment.
Truly, he's splendor in human form. And so, though granted entry by sentries at the door and ushered in by a guardian of the throne, my vision is blinded by his brilliance. And so it is. I'm turned away without even a word.
Here is his majesty.
Come, my lord king.
Welcome, masters. Cheers for the two masters, please. Why is it that when it's the class time, do both masters come here together?
Please listen, your majesty. I learned the art of dramatic expression from a real master. I've given so many performances. I'm patronized by the king and queen.
I'm well aware of that. So what?
Even then, I've been insulted by Haradatta. In the presence of nobles, he said I didn't even compare to the dust at his feet.
Your Majesty, he was in fact the instigator. The difference between him and me is like the ocean and a puddle. You should test our knowledge and technique. As a connoisseur, Your Majesty, this is our only chance.
An honest request, I would say.
Great idea. Your discerning Majesty deserves to listen.
Hold on. The Queen will suspect favoritism. She must be present along with the sister Kashiki if the hearing is to be fair.
Your grace is most right.
Whatever pleases your majesty.
Madagalya, after explaining the situation, ask the queen to come here with Sister Kaushiki.
As you command. This way, my queen.
Sister, how do you rate Haridasa and Gandhadasa? Don't worry, your favorite won't lose. Gandhadasa is his rival superior.
But even then, the king's favor gives Haridasa an unfair advantage.
Oh, your majesty, remember that as a queen, you too have a share. For a fire burns ever more brilliant by absorbing the sun, while the moon grows bright when embraced by the night.
Oh, Queen Zarini has arrived, led by her companion, Sister Kaushiki.
I see her. Adorned with the sacred ornaments, accompanied by Kaushiki in ascetic robes, she shines like three Vedas, embodying with the wisdom of the soul.
Long live the king.
Salutations, sister.
May you live for 100 autumns as husband to Dharini and the earth, both equal in endurance as the sources of life's great bounty.
Long live my noble king.
Welcome, my queen. Sister, please sit down. Sister, there is a contest between noble Haridasa and Gunadasa about their respective skills. You should sit between them as a judge.
Spare me the embarrassment. Do you appraise jewels in a city or a village?
It's not like that, Sister Kaushiki. In fact, we are impartial, whereas Queen and I could be partial.
The king is right. Sister Kaushiki is unbiased and qualified to assess her virtues and faults.
Then let the debate begin.
Dance is a matter of practice, actually. So why have a contest of words? What do you think, my queen?
If you ask me, this whole thing is annoying.
Your majesty, don't fear that I'd be defeated by one with equal skill.
Your grace, let's watch the ram's butt heads. You are paying them, aren't you?
You love a good fight, don't you?
No, it's not like that. When two mad elephants want to fight each other, the only way there is peace is when one is defeated.
Sister, haven't you seen both of them excel in their own expertise?
Surely.
Then it's settled. Let them prove who is the better.
That's exactly what I'm saying. One may rely on actions to demonstrate his individual skill, while another may have a special talent for teaching. But only he who excels in both should be made the head teacher.
Both teachers have heard, Sister Kaushiki. The decision shall be made on a display of teaching.
That's fine by us. As you say, my queen.
Is it a teacher's fault when a dull student watches a lesson?
My queen, that's why they say, even with a bad student, a good teacher's intellect shines through.
Oh God, now what? My husband's enthusiasm is for his heart's desire. Stop this, Ilya.
The queen speaks the truth. Gandhadasa, by teaching music, you're eating offerings made for Saraswati Devi. Why compete when you could lose?
Yes, the queen speaks the truth, but on this occasion, a man who fears a fight, believing that he has a secure position, suffers the contempt of others. When they say his learning is merely used to make a living, he is branded a peddler hawking knowledge.
But you just took on your student. It's unfair to present things that haven't sunk in yet.
Even then, I'm confident, my queen.
In that case, show Sister Kaushiki your lessons.
My queen, this isn't right. Even the all-knowing Buddha would arrive at a flawed decision if he were the sole judge.
Oh God, this foolish nun, you make me sleep even when I'm wide awake.
Why turn your bright face away from the king without reason? A wife has power over her husband, so there must be a cause for anger.
Oh, there's definitely a reason. She wants to protect her favorite. Luckily, Gandhadasa, you've been saved by the queen's feigning anger. Well-trained artists become experts by teaching.
My queen, this is what people are thinking. Please understand. I want to demonstrate my teaching skills in the contest. But if you forbid it, you'll deprive me of such a great chance.
Lord, what's the way out now? A teacher is responsible for every student.
Then my worry is unfounded. The queen permits it, so please tell me, Your Majesty, which aspect of the drama shall I use to demonstrate my teachings?
Whatever Sister Kaushiki suggests.
I think the queen has something in mind.
Speak freely. I only have power over my attendants.
And me, of course, she means.
Speak now, sisters.
Your Majesty, they should demonstrate the challenging 4-part Chalikam dance choreographed by Sarvishtha. That way, we'll see their students perform the same thing. It's the only way we'll know who is the better teacher.
As you command, sister.
In that case, both parties should arrange a dance performance in the theatre. When ready, a message should be sent to His Grace, but in fact, the very sound of Nridangam will inform us.
So it is.
May you be victorious.
Wait, come here.
Yes?
I'm speaking as a judge now. Since you will be demonstrating various facets of your expertise, your students should not take the stage without costume.
Oh, come on. We don't need such advice.
Wouldn't it be great if the great king would use such clever tactics in the matters of state?
You have misunderstood me, clever one. I didn't plan this. Then again, people with similar talents are usually jealous of each other.
Oh, the music's begin. A beating drum rouses the heart. And like a peacock's ball, the echoing vibrations rise and harmonize with the middle note. While peahens turn their necks upward, expecting a thundering rain cloud.
My queen, let's go and watch her. Let's watch it. Let's watch it.
Shameless.
We should go slowly. Queen Dalini might get suspicious.
Don't come, I'm excited by that seductive drum beat, sound drop down.